Java concept, you can acquire any another language also, like Python and JavaScript. Why? Because the Java, in Java you can see the code internally what is going to happen, but in another language everything is, you know, inbuilt, so it's difficult to understand internal part. But in Java I can see that. So what you have to do, you know, like if you will start the Java concept, then you have to download the JDK software. Okay, JDK is a software. Okay, just go through that, and you can see this in Oracle. And now if you have already, right? Okay, so you know the installation process and all, right? So if you want, then I can skip this, otherwise you can. Okay, no problem. Okay, no need that. Okay, so now actually I am using edit plus one editor is there. You can use Eclipse, no problem. Okay, so this is my edit plus editor. So first we will understand how Java code will work. Got it, right? So when you are executing Java code, okay, so just give me a second, I can show you one thing. Genius. So here when you are executing your Java code, so first what you have to do, this is my editor and this is my editor, like, so how to save, like I'm going to save bank test. So this is okay. So now we'll understand this few line of the code, why we are writing and how internally it is going to happen. So we have a first dot java file, right? So if you are a developer and you are starting the code, so this is called your source code. Source code means just we have developed this code. We did not execute this code. Right? We did not execute. Yeah, that is called source code. But this file I have saved in the .java extension, you can see. So this file is called .java file. But how to start this coding, right? So you can see. So we have a class keyword and this is called your class name. If you will think about of Java coding, so this is, we have a 53 keyword and 48 keyword we are going to use that. Inside this we have a one keyword that is called class keyword. Okay, but we have a many question, why we write this class keyword, what is the use of this class keyword, right? Okay, so we know that Java is object-oriented programming language. Got it, right? Java is, okay, one more guy want to join this session. I pinged already, you know, but these guys are not replying. Okay. Yeah, so they should at least reply, right? So I can make it the group and I can, okay, so I don't want to discontinue my flow, so I will send this recording session and they can go through that, right? Because we have a importance of timing. I committed this, we need to come 8:30, I need to start, then we need to start, right? Okay, so we have a class keyword. So my question is, why we are writing this class keyword? Okay, so simply, if you will go in the real world object, real world means if you will go in the in real world, this all are object, right? Sim, computer, bank, employee, cab, flight, railway. Okay, so if like I have a one requirement, I need to start my online classes, right? And my this is my business, I want to start in online session, right? So we need one application for my business, right? So my application, so at least my application, my institute having the some name, right? Like we have a name of Engineers Tech Hub. So what is the Engineers Tech Hub? real world object, right? So all are the real world object.
Okay. Okay.
Yes.
Yes,
yes, yes. Real world object. But the how to automate this real world object, right?
Okay.
So that real world object, how to represent into the programming world? Got it, right? This real world object, how to convert into the programming world? If you will go in the any website like Amazon, this is what someone will think, we need to start my business. So Amazon is what? Real world object. They have converted into the programming world. Got it, right? So what is the use of this class keyword? This class keyword, simply we have, you know, this real world object, but how to tell to the Java, right? How to Java will understand if you will execute your code. So the use of this class keyword, whatever this real world object is there, it will be converted into the programming world.
Anything.
See, I have given the example of net banking. So real world object, and we have converted into the programming world. Programming means we have a automation, right? So net banking, automated, if you will go in the www.hdfc.com, e-commerce, automated, right? Redverse, automated, right? IRCTC. So you're in your mind, some question is there, right? We are learning this class keyword converted into the programming world. If someone will use Python, then also in Python everything is an object. Whatever you are require programming, object oriented programming language, internally we have a same concept. Got it, right? So when we are going to start to develop this application, so first real world we have converted into the programming world, you know, how to convert into the programming world. So Java will understand because of this keyword. And when you are writing any, this is called class name. Class name is what? Real world object. Real world object, why we are writing this? Because we have to convert into the programming world. Got it, right? So we have some block, you can see this block. So this block is called class block. Okay. We have a many question here. So first thing, we are in the earlier stage dot Java file. Okay. Now in Java, when you are installing the JDK software, we have an inbuilt three software, compiler, JRE and JVM. Got it, right? So when you install this JDK, Java Development Kit, you know, kit itself, we have a something. So inside this, we have a JVM. Inside this, we have a JVM, we have a JRE, right? We have a compiler. Your question is why we need it, right? So when you are writing anything here, okay. So in my this edit plus, we have a shortcut called control 1. So when I will press control 1, you can see the code will compile. So what is the use of compiler? Compiler will check the syntax. Compiler is only, execute which is applicable for the Java programming. If you will write something, then compiler only tell you, hey, what are you doing? You are writing the wrong code. Error. Got it, right? In Eclipse, when you are writing anything, only that time it compilation happen. Auto compilation. See, this red mark is coming, right? Got it, right? So this is your, you can see why we are learning Java. This is your Selenium project. Got it, right? So if you are good in the Java, you can handle Selenium very easily. So we will focus on completely depth in the Java concept. And if you will go in the interview, they can ask 80% question from the Java only. So we will make our profile is unique. So what we understand here, we understand why we use compiler. So compiler will check only the syntax of the code. Okay, if you will write something, then what happen? You will get compile time error. Got it, right? Any doubt till now? No, right? So your question is compiler only checking the syntax. If I will execute this code, then what happen? This JVM is not able to understand my language. Whatever you have written is not able to understand. Then what happen? Compiler is doing multiple job. One job of the compiler is it will check the syntax. If everything is fine, it will convert, dot class file. It will generate dot class file. So what is the dot class file? So dot class file is your machine code or byte code. I will show you. See, this is called dot class file. So when you compile the code, this file will be generated automatically by compiler. This file only able to understand this JVM. Got it right? This file. Yes, go ahead. If there is no compile time error, then it will generate dot class file. Dot class file is nothing but it is a byte code or is it is a machine code. Only JVM is able to understand this code. Got it right? So this is the job of compiler. Okay, so now we understood, and now we are in which steps? We are in this step only. Even we did not compile this code. Now I am going to compile. Okay, you can see if I press Control 1, compile successfully. Okay, so now we have a many question. How to start? Where we have to write? This block is called class block. But in class block, what you can write? Got it right? So now we have just, I want to. I think you know that regarding this, right? Yeah. So what do you know about of that? No, I am not writing hello world. Only I am writing hello. Okay. So someone will ask, what is this line of the code? How you can explain? Hey, you can tell anything, no problem. Okay. Then I will explain. Okay. Okay. So now, okay, so we will understand. Okay, this guy is calling. Okay, I think he is very interested to join. One second, okay. Okay, because if I will not respond, no. Okay. So just we are learning. I will tell you if you don't know how to configure the Java installation and all. So tomorrow I will give you the backup class, or we can tell in the class only. Okay, so now we are going to understand how to start your Java coding. So if you start your Java coding, then in your system you must have a JDK software. So how to install the JDK and all, I will discuss tomorrow session. Okay, if you don't know, I will discuss. Okay, and now we are going to just I have started how to start your Java code, right? So this is my Edit Plus software. Okay, then how to do the configuration and all. If you have a comfortable with any other editor, you can do the practice no problem at all. Even you can use the Eclipse also, no problem at all. So now we are going to understand how to start your Java coding. So when you are starting any Java code, then you have to save your file. I have started recording, right? Yeah, so you have to save your file in the .java extension. Okay, so I save this file in the .java extension, and you can see this is the class keyword and this is your class name. So why we are writing this class keyword? Okay, so because if you will start any business, then any business we need to automate that business, right? So what we can do, your real world object we have to convert into the programming world, right? Everything is your real world object. You can go through this Amazon website. This is what we have. Someone will think in the mind will come, we can start the online shopping business, right? So this Amazon is what? Before it was an object only. Flipkart is an object only. Then how to convert into the programming world? So programming world is nothing but this is your automation, right? This real world object we have converted into the programming world. Okay, and this is your, you know, net banking, e-commerce, Redbus, IRCTC, MyTrip. These are the real world we have converted into the programming world. How to convert real world into the programming world? We use class keyword. Class keyword means when you are writing any real world object, it will convert into the programming world. This block is called class block. So in Java, how to execute? Now we are learning how to start Java coding, how to run your Java code, right? We are learning this thing internally, what is going to happen when you are executing your code. So dot Java file I have saved here. Now what you have to do, you have to do here, be if you will install the JDK software, inside this we have a three more software, that is the inbuilt software that is called JRE, compiler and JVM. So what is the use of this? So compiler will check the syntax of the code. If you will write anything, you can see we will get compile time error. So it is checking the syntax of the code. If you will execute this completely, if you will execute, then what happened? Compiler will generate one dot class file. So you can see we have a dot class file. Compiler will generate dot class file. So what is the dot class file? Dot class file is nothing but it is your machine code, or it is a byte code. So JVM, this JVM software is not understand whatever the code you have written. JVM software won't be understand whatever the code you have written here. He only, JVM only understand this dot class file, means bytecode only. So the what is the use of compiler? Compiler use is it will check the syntax of the code. If any error is there which is not applicable for the Java code, it will throw compile time error. Okay, or if it will execute, then it will generate dot class file. Okay, so this is the use of compiler. So now we have another question, what we can write inside this block, this class block, right? So we are going to write something here. So this is your what? Hi Java. Okay, so what is this? I forget your name, Sam, right? You were telling regarding this code. Yeah, so can you explain that? See, if you will interact with each other, no, we will get more clarity. Okay, so my question is, did this will compile the code or not? Okay, let's see. Okay, when I will compile this code, we are getting some error. Okay, you can see illegal startup type error. Okay, so I told you, right? We are starting from zero level and we will make it the strong basics. We will not stuck anywhere. If you're good in the basics, no, but never you will stuck anywhere, okay? But we have a question, why we are getting compile time error? So first conclusion is, yeah, sure. No, here there is no we have only class block, right? So here nothing to need to close and all. So we will understand. This block is called, complete block is called class block. Okay, opening and closing here. Inside this block, we will write only logic. Sorry, inside this block, we cannot write the logic directly. So what do you meaning of logic? Logic is, there are two types of the logic. One is your business logic and one is your mathematical logic. Okay, there are two types of the logic. I can tell you in the real time. This is your Amazon site. So when you are going to here, when you will go here, then we have a one registration page, right? When you are entering your value, then you will get username and password. That is called one logic. Payment gateway, right? You are adding this add cart. That is your logic. You are adding, no, you are adding and deleting. So as a class block, we cannot write a logic directly. So your question is, then why we are getting this error here? So this system is a class, out is a variable, and println is a method. So this is your inbuilt logic written by the Java people. So you can understand easily. I can show you the implementation of system class. Where is my source code? Okay, so if you will go in this, actually when you are installing the Java, right? So when you are installing the Java, we have a many inbuilt classes, interface, method, variable. So inside this lang package, we have a system class. Okay, this is your system class. I'm going to open this class. So this is my class, which is developed by the Java people. So what it is? It is a logic, right? What logic they have written? You can print any data. We understand only one line of the code, right? And printing this value. But how it is printing? Because this is the inbuilt logic developed by the Java people. Okay, so you can say this system is a what? Class. Got it, right? And inside this, we have a this method, println. You can, you know, I can print anything. You can say boolean type, char array type, double type, float type, int type, long type. Got it, right? So we can print any type. So what is the conclusion of that? Conclusion is, as a class level, we cannot write any logic directly. Any doubt regarding this statement? Yes. Yeah. Is a inbuilt class. I can show you. This is the implementation developed by the Java people. Okay. And out is a variable. You can see this is the variable. Out is a variable. Okay. And I did not teach you what is variable and what is method. Coming session, we will teach you. But yeah, now we need to. Oh, okay. No. Coming session, I will tell you what is the variable. Okay, and I will also tell you what is the method. Now only we will discuss why method is required. Okay, you can see this is the user defined class and this is your inbuilt class. Inbuilt class means the Java people is already developed and given to you. You can use this. I can show you how many things they have given to you to use this. If we will go in the Java documentation, You can let's see. I think this one or these are the inbuilt classes, not this one. Or simply we can see in the source code only. Okay, you can see these are the classes already they have developed, but we need to use this. How to use this, right? Got it, right? So this is the system, the class the Java have implemented. Out is a variable and println is a method. So I will discuss what is the variable and what is the method. Okay, so here my agenda is how to start your Java, what you can write, what you cannot write, and why we are writing, where we will write. Got it, right? This concept I think clear. Mandeep, are you able to understand? Hello, Mandeep, are you able to understand what we are discussing? Okay, he's on mute. Okay, so no problem. Okay, no problem. Okay, so your question is then how to print this? Got it, right? So if you want to write any logic, then Java people have given the concept of method concept. Okay, so first question is why method? Okay, first question is why method? Method means if you want to write any logic, then we need a method concept. Your question is first we understood why. Because why is the answer why we are implementing the things, right? Why we are creating the things. So if you have any logic, then first we can write what we can create a method. So you should not understand what I am writing here, okay? Because you will get confused. So just I am going to write login page, okay? But I will tell you what I am writing, so no worry about of that. Just what you have to understand now, this is called your user defined method. User defined method means we have developed. Got it, right? You should not understand what is a static void, just you can understand. You can see we have a now two block. One is your class block and one is your method block. You can see, right? So you know, as a class block, sorry, as a class block, first is that we cannot write a logic as a class level directly. If you want to write a logic, then we need to create a method. Inside this method, you can only write the logic. Okay, so I have created one method. This method is called a static method. Now your question is coming in your mind, why we are writing a static, why we are writing void, right? Got it, right? And just we will understand later this, okay? My agenda is this one. We need to execute this code only. This is my today is my agenda. Okay, so now I and this is just we can understand this is your static and void. I will later we will tell, and this is your method name and this is your parameter, and we are writing inside this. Before I was getting error, right? If I will compile now, you can see I am not getting any error. So what is the conclusion of that? The conclusion is we cannot write a logic as a class level. If you want to write a logic, then we need to create a method. Got it, right? So my job is completed till now here, right? Still we need to interact with JVM. So now I compile this code And now I'm going to execute this code. Okay, I told you, right? In Java, we need to do compilation and we need to do execution. Compiler job is different and execution job is different, right? So now I'm going to, in my system, we have a control 2. Control 2 means I will execute this code. You can see still I'm getting this another error. You can read this error. Main method not found in class. Please define the main method. This is the another problem. I am not interacting with JVM. He is asking where is your main method. Now you know why I jump in the method concept, because the main is a, you know, here we need to understand the terminology of this method. This is asking where is your main method, not found in your class. Actually, what happened, this software, someone is developed this software, right? JDK. So we have a compiler and we have a JVM and we have a JRE. So now JRE will come where we will use this JRE. So I'm not discussing this. Now we have focus on this two internal software. So this JVM developer who developed the JVM, and we are the developer user. We are the user, right? So how to interact my code with the JVM? Got it, right? Okay, so we need some interface between users and JVM software, right? So what happened, this JVM software guy, you know, they want to do something. If you will write anything, user, we are the user, it must be interact with, you know, JVM. So they have created one common method that is called main method. Your question is, why method only he has created? Got it, right? They can create another concept to interact with the JVM. Okay, so we have a multiple method. This is the one static method, right? Non-static method. We have a another also method, return type, non-return type. Then JVM cannot understand, no, which method you are going to create. Yes. Yes. Okay. I will little bit explain the method concept here, okay? Then you will understand. You will get more clarity, okay? So first we need to understand why method is required, right? So, okay. So now I'm coming this. So when you are creating a method, we have a, Java has given some syntax of the method. One is called accessibility modifier. Wait. One second. This is the complete syntax of method, okay? I will tell you why main method is right required. So when you are creating any method, we need a one syntax that is called accessibility modifier. Accessibility modifier. This and another is called non-accessibility modifier. I'm not writing complete, okay? So English, just avoiding that, okay? And we have a return type. Okay, we have a method name. Okay, and this is your parenthesis and this is your this one. This is the complete syntax of method. Okay, so now we have this accessibility modifier is optional. Your question is, what is the accessibility modifier? So there are four types of the accessibility modifier. One is your public, private, protected and default. Public means you can access anywhere. Protected means you can access within the protected means subclass, you can access the another subclasses. And default means you are not writing anything. By default, it is you can access within the package. Okay, and public means we can use anywhere, and private means we can only access within the class. So this thing we will understand later. Okay, so I am coming on in your point. Okay, so now you can see public static void m1. Okay, and we are writing something. I will explain that. Okay, so this is your complete syntax of the method. You can see public means accessibility modifier. Why we are writing the public? You can access anywhere. A static is called non-accessibility modifier. Okay, so why we use the static keyword? We have another topic called a static and non-static control flow. So from there I will discuss in deeply. Okay, just I am giving the overview of them. Okay, and void is your return type, and this is your method name, and this is your parenthesis. Okay, so accessibility modifier means this is your optional. We can use according to the project requirement. This is also optional. We can use according to the project requirement. Return type is mandatory. What is your return type? Void is your return type. And method name is also mandatory. Got it, right? And this block is called method block. So your question, if I will not write void, you can see what will happen. Invalid method declaration, return type required. You can see compiler is telling you. Got it, right? So this is the complete syntax of method. If you are writing anything, if you are creating a method, return type must be there. But return type is also divided, okay? Non-void type and void type. We have a complete method, topic is there. Okay, so I will come on that session, because if you will go inside this, we will again start a new topic. Okay, so my focus is this one only right now. I think you got little bit idea about of that, why we are writing this void keyword. Got it, right? And why we are writing a static keyword and public keyword. I will give you the session. Okay, even I will explain here also. So we have a multiple method. I can tell you, you know, this is your one method, and another method is called non-void, non-static method. This is called your non-static method. Okay, so I will tell you what is the if you are not using any static keyword, that is called non-static. We have a return type, we have a non-return type, we have a return type with return a statement, return with value. Many types of the method is there. Okay, so someone will ask, this type of the method is there, then why the JVM people have developed main method? Got it, right? So if you creating any method, okay, if you creating any method, then what you have to call this method. Okay, then what happened? We are here now only. Okay, so in JVM software, they have written the logic for main method. Got it, right? So when you will execute any code, your JVM will search main method. So JVM developer have developed one method. This is the common method. So when you execute the code, no, then JVM only search the main method. Where is your main method? Then control will come here only. Got it, right? So what is the conclusion of that? The main method is your interface between the JVM and users. Got it? So before, if I will not execute this, compiler is not worry about of main method. Is there or not? He is not compiler is not caring about that. But JVM is, JVM is only looks like the main method. Okay. So your question is how they are calling this method. So what happened? Because JDK is a software, right? So they have developed the main method code inside this software. So it will call automatically when you will execute the code. JVM, search the main method, and JVM, if main method is there, automatically called by the JVM. So calling a statement is there inside this JVM, main method calling a statement, right? So that's why we are writing the main method. Got it, right? So now understood, right? So now I have written main method. Your question is that you can see I am not printing hello world. It is a very any people will start Java, then it will start from the hello world. Okay, so we are Java is very easy. No. You will also play with Java. Okay, you can see. Did you? I think you try to understand the Java, but not like that the people are explaining. Because we have a more confusion why we are writing. Still, you have a confusion of this, right? But slowly, slowly, we'll come on that all the point. You can see. I will come on that. Public is what? Accessibility modifier. Why we they have written the public? Means you can access anywhere, right? If they will make it the private, then it will not access. It will access within the only classes. Your question is what is a static? Okay? I will explain what is a static. So I will tell you why the static keyword. Okay? So now you can see little bit. I will give you idea about of a static and non-static. So we have a string bank name. A string is a type. I will tell you, just you can think this is your variable. Okay, variable, little bit idea about a variable. Okay, so this is your a string bank name, and we have a string IFSC code. Okay, this is the bank name and IFSC code. You can see we have a this is like HDFC bank or any bank is there. Where is that here? Okay, this is the bank, and inside this bank we have 100 customer or 1000 customer. These are the customer. Okay, here the question is this customer having the common bank name for the all the customer, right? And IFSC code is also common. So the static keyword means if you are writing a static keyword, we have a single copy of memory and memory. Okay, so what happened? That memory is provided by the JVM only. Got it? You should not create any memory for that, because if you are writing anything, it is just storing in somewhere, right? So a static means we have a single copy of memory, and non-static means we have a specific copy of memory. Yes. Yes. Yeah. I will explain once you will get more clarity. Okay, then you can. Okay, so just this is the common. If you have a common thing. If you want only single copy of memory, then we will use a static keyword. Why? Because I will get only one copy of memory, so my code performance is good. But if you will write, this is the customer name, right? Customer name. If you will write customer name or mobile number, okay? Or pan card, okay? So what happen? This customer, if you will make it this static, then what is the effect of there? I'm going to explain between a static and non-static. This customer want to change this mobile number. Got it right? Then what happen? It if you will affect in the another customer, another customer, another customer, because we have a single copy for a static. Got it right? So in this place we will not use a static. Why? Because every customer I want a specific copy of memory. Yeah, because all the customer having the different data. So here we cannot use a static. Yeah, bank name is a static for all the customer, right? Every customer, yeah. That's why this is a static. This is common for all the code. Got it, right? Okay, so that's why we have written a static. And void, I told you, right? This is your return type. This is your method syntax. So if you will not write the void keyword, if you will remove this, you can see this compiler is showing, invalid method declaration. Return type must be required. And it is showing. Yeah. And so we have a many return types. I will discuss why we are writing void also in the coming session. Okay, so this is your void and this is your main method. Main is a what? Name only. This one M1, they have given the common method name is what? Name. That's it. And they are passing the two. This is your parameter only. So what is this? This is like, when we are creating a variable int a equal to 10. So what happened? They have used here array. You know little bit idea about a array concept? Okay, no problem. So what is this? This is called 1D array, and this is your variable name. So your question is, what is this yaar? What is why we are writing this, right? Just you can understand, if you want to store multiple data in a single variable, then we should go for array concept. So coming session, we have a separate session for array. In this variable, you can store multiple data, multiple value, multiple object. So this JVM people have given this parameter as a array, a string type, and this is your variable name only. Got it right? So just they, yeah, this is same. This is same. Yes. Okay. I think you should not have any doubt regarding main method, but we will explore everything. We are discussing public, we are discussing a static, we are discussing void, we are discussing method name, we are discussing parameter, all the things having the separate topic for that. Okay, so if I will compile this code, then you can see what will happen, what the output will come. Let's see. Now everything is going fine. Compile this code and execute this code. But you can see only this one is executing. Why this two is not executing? Yes. Okay, I will tell you. Okay. So main method having the automatic call by the JVM. Okay, when you will execute our main method is there, then what happens? JVM look like the main method, then control will come here and it will execute, and again control will come back to the main method. when you are creating user defined method, you must be call this method. Okay, so if you will not call this method, it won't be executed. So this is your static method. So a static method you can call directly. Okay, so how it will execute? When, see how it will execute. Actually, I don't have a screen diagram, so I can show you execution flow. So just I want. So what happened when class is loaded into the JVM? Then JVM will look like where is your main method. Then control will enter inside this. Okay. When control will enter, then method is executing from top to bottom. Got it, right? So now it is executing line by line. So here it is executed, then it will print this line. Then again control will come M1. Then this M1, JVM will search where is your M1. Then it will search inside this class. Then what happened? The control will go inside this. Okay, then this method will execute. Again, control come back to the main method. This is the execution of how this method is executing. Now I'm able to execute, right? I think you got some idea why we are using main method. Why we are not using, why the JVM people have developed the main method. Why user defined method is not required. Why they did not use the user defined method? Because they don't know. JVM doesn't know which method you are going to create, right? Got it, right? So this is the overview of your code. You can see we have a non-static method, but you can see non-static method we cannot call directly. If you will call this directly, we will get something error. I told you, right? M1 having a static method. So a static method already memory is provided by the JVM, right? But non-static method. Yeah, but M2 is what? Non-static method. Non-static method JVM is not providing the memory. We need to create an object. Okay, so how to create an object? So tomorrow I will discuss. Okay, same timing, no problem, right? Okay, so same timing. Okay.